We are speaking with the ever interesting, as I like to call him, John Waters. Thank you so much for talking to us this morning. Sure. Tell me about Valentine's Day. You're doing something kind of neat to celebrate, I guess, love and
well,
the
yes,
ever cool personality.
I'm doing my stand-up show at the Soundstage, where I do my Christmas show every year, too. Sort of my home here. And yeah, I'm going to tell you about love. I'm going to tell you what to do, what to give people for Valentine's present, what's not to do. You know, I don't give anybody candy. I got dosed once by a fan. So you don't want to ever, I'm afraid to eat any food that anybody gives me, even though I love candy, especially See's candy, my favorite.
Hint, hint, hint.
Yeah, yeah. No, yeah. So, but I'm afraid if people give it to me to eat anything, yeah. You know, you don't eat stuff. So it's just what to do on Valentine's Day. You know, it's a scary day for a lot of people because they either feel lonely or they're going to make the wrong thing or they go overboard with it. You demand a reaction. It's a scary day. It's a massacre for a lot of people.
Tell me about some of your fond memories or maybe crazy memories of Valentine's Day.
Well, I used to always go to the butcher on Valentine's Day and get a chicken heart and or a turkey, a animal heart, and gift wrap it sort of and give it to the man I like, kind of like the Wicked Queen gave the prince the Snow White in the heart, right? And they always seemed to like it and took their clothes off.
So that's what we should all be doing, is going grabbing chicken hearts.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, it depends on
where
your partner,
yes.
If your partner would appreciate that.
Might not be a good first date. I don't know.
Well, it depends. Even coming to see me as a first date is tricky. You're either, I've met people that got married after they saw Pink Flamingos for the first time. And I've met people that never spoke again, you know, so it's a date breaker either way. I think it'll go favorably.
Will we laugh, cry? What will we do if we come see the show?
I don't think you'll cry. I mean, I hope not.
Maybe cry with laughter?
Well, that's always good. Yeah, I never understood that. But yes, I think you'll definitely laugh. Maybe at things that you never laughed about before. That's the point.
How much do you enjoy doing that stand-up in this part of your life?
I enjoy doing because I'm always writing new material. Like right when I go home, I'm in the middle of writing this one. So I'll go at 8 o'clock, I'll go back in and write. I enjoy it. It's my job. You know, I mean, it's not, people say, do you have fun? Well, no, I'm at work. But I like work.
Tell me about Trump. He gave his State of the Union speech last night. We've talked to you a little bit about him in the past. What are your thoughts about the state of the country, given what's happened in the White House?
We're in a civil war. And I don't believe anything he said about trying to negotiate and everything because he's not very good at that. And I can't help looking at him. He now looks like a white James Brown impersonator. And I believe he'll go down as the worst president we've ever had in history. So I'm not for him, obviously. And Pence is even so scary back there sitting behind him. Oh, he's even scarier. And that wife is even scarier than all of them.
What do you think should be or could be the message? What do you think people should do? I mean,
build a wall around him and the White House and keep him in from going to Europe and embarrassing us. But I get why Republicans hate liberals sometimes because of ludicrous political correctness and ludicrous. I get why we're easy targets. And I'm afraid the Democrats are going to fracture and have all these left-wing, and then we're going to lose again. And I say that when I yell to people, so who are you going to vote for? And they're silent. Because we all should be, if you're anti-Trump, every person should know who you're going to vote for. And we don't, because there's so many candidates. So I'm fearful.
What can we do, though, to bring everybody together? Obviously, we're not going to see everything apart.
That. And that's why I say in my show, I get why some Trump people love how pissed off he gets us. I see that. You know what I mean? And I get why, too, because you can't make your opponent feel stupid. You can't, you have to listen. I'm an anti-separatist. I know people that voted for Trump. Tab Hunter voted for Trump. So, you know, I'm not saying that I don't know people that did. But it feels like a civil war, but nobody's changing anybody's mind these days. That seems to be the big problem, and I don't know the answer. The answer is voting.
Tell me about some advice you would have for a couple. Let's do couples and then singles on Valentine's Day.
Well, a couple don't expect too much. That's the thing. Don't expect this great love that you saw when you were a child in a Walt Disney movie. Maybe there is no such thing as that. You have to negotiate that too. And singly, well, get a lawyer if you want to ask someone for a date these days.
And how successful and how pleased were you with the art exhibit that you did?
Oh, great. I was really, and I just came back from Columbus, Ohio, where it opened at the Wexner Center. The whole show just moved there, so I just did the whole new thing in a different surrounding. Oh, it was great. I mean, the attendance was amazing, and a lot of people in the museum had never been there. So I was very, very, very proud of that.
What gets John Waters up every morning? I always wondered this. What makes you happy? What gets you going? And why keep putting one foot in front of the other?
Well, every morning on the weekday, I get up at 6, and I start writing at 8 o'clock. Every day, my job is to think up something weird. And in the afternoon, I run my business. So I like my job, so that's why I get up. I don't ever get up and think, oh, God, I have to go to work. Generally, I like my work, and I'm my own boss. That really helps.
And how about on the movie front? When are we going to see another movie?
You probably won't, because I've made 17 movies. You know, it's not like...
Well, anything else? I mean, are there any other productions?
They keep paying me. The HBO paid me to write a sequel to Hairspray. They didn't make it. I had a children's movie called Fruitcake that I was paid to write. It never got made. So they can keep doing that. That's fair. That's fair.
What have you not done that you want to do? What's on your bucket list?
Well, I've...
That's for a G-rated audience.
I haven't done a rap album.
Oh, okay. Is that what you want to do?
But in my new book, I sort of describe my fantasy of being a rock star. So, yes. I mean, there's all things that I haven't done. But I think if I thought I could do them, I would have tried it already.
And what kind of success do you think Baltimore will see in the future? What most concerns you about the city, and how do you think we can get to a good place?
The thing that most concerns me is what's always concerned me here, is that our neighborhoods are the strongest thing, but nobody leaves their own neighborhood, so they don't cross over in there. That's why segregation is still so bad. That's why racism. Now, everybody's afraid to leave their safe zone. And I always said years ago that it should be like jury duty. Once a year, every person has to move to the economically opposite neighborhood of where they live now, send their kids to school for a week, get their hair done, and go to a bar, and everything would change.